Okay, hello girls. Welcome back to 2.3, Male Organ for Transpiration. So we are going to recall on the meaning of transpiration, and that is the process of water loss in the form of water vapor through evaporation from the plants to the surrounding. Okay, we know that transpiration takes place all over the parts of the plant, and that includes the stem, the flower, and the leaves. But mainly, about 90% of water loss is through the stomatal pores, okay, or the openings here at the leaf. Okay, and that answer our questions on which is actually the main organ for transpiration. And we know also that water will diffuse into the root. Okay, so that means the uptake of water by a plant adalah melalui dia punya akar. So the roots will be the one absorbing the absorbing the water together with the dissolved mineral salts. And then from here, is it is the red arrow here indicates the water movement. Jadi dia akan naik sepanjang dia punya batang. Okay, through xylem. Okay, don't forget xylem being the vessels to transport water and also mineral salts. Dia akan pergi sehingga ke daun. Dan tempat daun ini, dia ada banyak lubang-lubang yang kita kenali sebagai stoma, and that is where those water evaporates to the atmosphere when the stoma is open. Okay, and this activity over here, batang sadari ini apabila dia direndam into this solution, the red eosin solution, after a few hours or after a while, you can actually see the trace the red lines over here. Maksudnya dia memang naik ini melalui xylem. Air berwarna merah ini. Dan sekali lagi membuktikan stoma daun itu adalah tempat utama berlakunya transpirasi. Okay, now why is transpiration required in plants? Okay, we know that the roots are the organs which are responsible to absorb water together with the dissolved mineral salts. Jadi dari mana? Daripada tanah. Okay, look back at the picture just now. Dari bawah ke atas, yaitu melawan daya tarikan gravity. Okay, sumber air dia berada dari bawah. Okay, so this, okay, straight away I go to the third point. It says produces a pulling force. Satu daya tarikan. Can you imagine that? Dari atas seolah-olah air dekat bawah ni ditarik. Ada satu daya penarik yang akan menarik air ini naik ke atas. And therefore, what's the importance or the significance is that this pulling force is able to move the water and the mineral salts continuously in the vessel, xylem vessels, from the roots to all the plant cells. Okay, so you can see how important transpiration is. Maksudnya dia mencetuskan daya tarikan dari atas. Seolah-olah ada satu daya yang menarik dari atas. Because it is not easy to move against the gravitational pull. But the movement of water and mineral salts against the gravitational pull is made possible because of this pulling force. Okay. Number two, the second point is that water also bring along this heat energy from the leaves. Dan bila dia menyejat sebagai water vapor, seolah-olah juga macam manusia selepas kita berpeluh, ada penyejatan peluh, kita rasa sejuk sikit, right? So same goes to the plant. So this transpiration is able to give a cooling effect to the plant. Seolah-olah tumbuhan ini berpeluh. Jadi proses penyejukan ataupun kesan penyejukan berlaku pada tumbuhan itu. Now, we are going to look at the various environmental factors that are affecting the rate of transpiration.